Club and Executive Director of 3D Space. We're a nonprofit in Los Angeles. We are going to be opening a museum of 3D. And you may be wondering, this is a Jack Kirby interview, what does that have to do with 3D? Well, we'll explain that. Let me let our other panelists introduce themselves first. Lawrence?
I'm Lawrence Kaufman. I'm the chairman of the National Stereoscopic Association. I'm also an officer on 3D Space and a bunch of other 3D organizations, and I'm a 3D comic book collector.
I'm Rand Hoppe. I'm the acting director of the Jack Kirby Museum.
I'm John Morrow. I'm a publisher of Tomorrow's Publishing. We do publishing called the Jack Kirby Collective and have had some association with Ray Zone on several of our publications.
Okay, so I'm sure you're all pretty familiar with Jack Kirby, but you may be not as familiar with Ray Zone. I'm curious, how many of you knew Ray? Okay, so there are some people out there. For those of you who didn't know Ray Zone, Ray passed away in 2012, but over his career, first off, he was given the name the King of 3D Comic Books. Jack was the king, but Ray was the 3D king. And Ray was an author, a publisher, a historian, filmmaker, and over the course of his career, he did the 3D conversion work on several hundred 3D comic books publications. And he did a couple of projects with Jack Kirby. Ray got his start in the 3D world. He'd been an avid comic book collector since childhood. Ray is the gentleman in the light, in the blue shirt, second from the right. This was actually the team that was at a company called 3D Video Corporation in the early 80s. They did a whole bunch of 3D TV broadcasts at local stations. And Susan Pinsky, who's pictured on the left of this photo, was in charge of putting together a publishing wing at 3D Video Corp. They decided to do a 3D comic book to promote their 3D television. And she read some writings about 3D that Ray Zone had done. She hired him to write a comic book that was called Battle for a Three-Dimensional World. And they hired Jack Kirby to do the art. I imagine based on the fact that Jack had done a 3D comic book in the 1950s. Randy, you want to talk about that one?
There was the back in the 3D craze.
Where's the mic close?
In the 3D craze of comics in the 50s, Simon and Kirby produced one issue of Captain 3D for Harvard Comics. Had a number of other artists work on it, like Steve Ditko and Mark Meskin, and they did one issue, and then the craze kind of faded, but they were there. Although Norman Maurer and Joe Kubert were the kind of like the pioneers. But yep, there it is.
Yeah, and this was a Harvey publication. Harvey got into the game of 3D. Actually, there were a whole bunch of 3D comic books between 1952 and 1954. But as the 3D movie craze died out, the 3D comic craze also died out. And of course, there were the congressional hearings that kind of killed all of the serious comic books at the time. But that's another thing.
Another thing about the 3D comics too was that they were very, very intensive work to separate them. It wasn't like using any kind of cameras and having how that production was, but
yeah,
flooding up the comics.
But yeah, the process in the 50s, they would actually do layers of acetate.
Yeah.
And they could do, I think it was six layers before you couldn't see through the acetate anymore. That way you could separate and have different planes of depth.
We have some of the planes of acetate from the Captain 3D rendering.
So, Ray was hired to write this comic book, Battle for a Three-Dimensional World, and he ended up working with Jack Kirby. Did all the art for the book. They also created a number of other promotional items. 7-Eleven, pay your 99 cents for a pair of glasses, you get a comic book with it, but then you use those glasses to watch Creature from the Black Lagoon or something when it aired on your local UHF channel. We have some images here from that. So this is the hero character that Ray wrote about in Jack Illustrated. That's Scary Hunter. And he's a 3D superhero, and his archenemy is Cyclops. So he doesn't see 3D.
He doesn't see 3D.
Ray wrote this, and Ray actually wrote it so that as you read the comic book, you got the history of 3D through the superhero characters. And it's interesting, Ray wrote this, but Ray didn't actually do the 3D work on it either. The 3D work on this was primarily done by Tony Alderson and a team of artists that he brought to the project. It was after this that Tony actually taught Ray how to do 3D comic book conversion, and Ray made a career of it. And these are all 3D. We have 3D glasses. Come on, we should work. So this is a page from the book.
I have to say, one of the things about the book when it came out, it was in by Mike Thibodeau, but one thing that was notable about it was that Jack had been working in comics for so long, and at the time he has been doing personal works like Captain Victory and Silver Star, I think, right? But when this came out, and it was clearly drawing the story written by Ray, the art was just almost like a throwback to his old superhero work, like that we hadn't really seen for a while. And that was kind of the revelation of it, to see when I finally got my hands on a copy of it. It's like, wow, this is like old superhero Jack that we haven't seen in a while. It's kind of fun.
So the promotional poster, that was 1982, and the book came out in 83, end of 82. And around that time, Ray discovered that anyone who wanted to could have their own public access TV show in Los Angeles. All you had to do was schedule a time, go down to this little tiny studio in Santa Monica, it was Root W, and they would record the show, and it would go out to all the cable networks in the Los Angeles area, so everyone in Los Angeles could watch anything you wanted to produce. So Ray created a show, he called it The Zone Show, and he invited all kinds of artists, underground artists, comic book artists, fine artists, musicians, to come on and discuss their art. And as he had gotten to work with Jack, in addition to this, they also did these honeycomb ads. How many of these were there? Three?
Four.
Four,
and
there.
I remember three.
And you worked on these, right? Again, these were by the serial, the poster,
the little poster in the back. And Mike inked those as well. And I think that might have been the first work that Mike inked.
He didn't come out until 84. So.
84. Okay. So this actually. Okay. Well, in 84, I must have been around when they were doing this then. Ray invited Jack to come on his cable access show. So, it was October 10th, 1984, they met in a studio in Santa Monica and sat down for a half-hour conversation. And it aired November 21st, 1984. And whatever audience was watching on Los Angeles Cable Access got to see this. And as far as I know, that's the only time that it ever aired. The tapes went into Ray's storage unit, and that was the last anyone saw of it. At one point, Ray did do a transcription of the interview, and that was published in Kirby Club magazine. But for for over 30 years, no one has seen the actual interview. And sadly, in 2012, Ray passed away. And he and I had been working together on a number of 3D projects. He was actually very instrumental in helping to get our nonprofit, he was the inspiration to get it started. And earlier this year, I was working with Ray's family to try to preserve parts of his collection for our museum. And I came across a box of old 3/4-inch videotapes that were labeled as Zone Show. So I have some equipment to digitize this stuff. I pulled the tape and hoped there was something still on it. Sure enough, the whole interview was there. So I contacted Brandon and said, you know, I worked with Ray Zone. Before I even got any further, he said, tell me you found the tape. So here we are, and you're going to get to see a half-hour interview, Ray Zone interviewing Jack Kirby for the first time in over 30 years. And I will preface this by saying it was a cable action show in the 80s. So I don't think I need to say any more. You'll understand when you see it. But it's a really interesting, fascinating interview. And we'll take a look at it.